Welcome to Arcaversity online lectures. In this lecture, I'm going to explain you how to calculate value of a firm under Modigliani and Miller approach when corporate taxes are present. In my previous lecture, I explained you how to calculate value of a firm in the absence of a corporate taxes. In the presence of a corporate taxes and in a current real world scenario, Modigliani and Miller argue that the tax advantage, that which is called as a tax shield, will help equity investors and value of the firm will increase. The firm that do not have any debt is called as unlevered firm, and the firm which uses debt in its capital structure is called as a levered firm. So we use two different equations. One is for calculating the value of a levered firm, and another is to calculate the value of an unlevered firm. Now I'll demonstrate that with an example. Here is an example. East Corporation has an operating income of $3 million, and which is in a 40% tax bracket. That is, the corporate tax is 40%, and its borrowing rate is a 14%, whereas equity capitalization rate is 18%, and the earnings of the company are not expected to grow irrespective of whether you use a total debt or an equity or a combination of a debt and equity. And all the earnings are paid out to the shareholders in the form of a dividend. In the presence of a corporate but no personal taxes, what is the value of a firm in an MM world with no financial leverage, that we call as an unlevered firm, and with a 4 million of a debt levered and 7 million of a debt levered firm? So value of unlevered firm, this equals to market value of equity. Because there is no debt, we directly take it as the market value of equity. When in case of value of levered firm, this equals to market value of equity plus present value of tax shield. So your present value of tax shield, this equals to debt times tax rate. So in our case, the tax rate is 40%. So first we calculate the value of unlevered firm, that is the EBIT, earnings before interest and tax. This equals to 3 million, and tax on this is 40%. So this equals to 1,200,000. So this is 1,800,000. Then your equity capitalization rate is equals to 18%. So 0.18. So value of unlevered firm is 1,800,000 upon 0.18 is the equity capitalization rate. So this is a 10 million. 10 million is the value of unlevered firm. Now in the case of a levered firm, you have two options. One is when you borrow 4 million of a debt, and second one is when a company borrows $7 million in debt. So our value of levered firm, this equal to market value of equity plus present value of a tax shield, that is debt times tax rate. Tax rate is, so here this equals to 10 million plus, in case of a debt, this is a 4 million times tax rate is 40%. So this equals to 10 million plus 1,600,000. This equals to 11,600,000 is the value of a firm when debt is 4 million. Now, here if you observe, with no lever, that is no debt in a capital structure, the firm's value is only 10 million. Whereas when a debt of 4 million is used, the value increases from 10 million to 11,600,000. Next is, what is the value of a firm when 7 million debt is used? In that case, so you have a 10 million plus 7 million is the debt times tax rate, that is 0.4. So this is 10 million plus 2,800,000 thousand. So this equals to 12,800,000 is the value of levered form when debt of 7 million is used. So this clearly indicates that the more debt that you use in your capital structure and when there is a corporate tax is present, the value of firm will increase. So this approach is similar to the net income approach. However, in net income approach, we don't consider the tax rate, whereas here the corporate tax rate is considered. Thank you. Thank you for watching the lecture.